I'm here at Outlaws Boxing, talking to boxer trainer Brandon Krause. Today, Brandon, what are you going to get a crash course in boxing? What are we learning today?
Well,
how to work the heavy bag?
One of my top fighters, David Ivana, is over here getting some bag work in, right?
Uh-huh.
He's working it pretty good. Now, the thing with a heavy bag or any piece of equipment in here is how well you can transfer the skills of real ring situations to this equipment. Because the equipment, what is it? It's inanimate. It's just a hanging bag of something. And it's how you work it that makes it effective or not. David, look, he's doing a very good job. Not staying in one spot, not staying stationary and just practicing how hard you can hit an inanimate object. He's moving, he's got his hands up, he's slipping, he's working different defense, he's mixing in combination punching along with hard shots, right? And David, let that bag suit you. Let me see more some movement. Now, he's working the bag. The bag isn't working him. He's doing things in order to make the bag react a certain way that will lead to other choices, right? To other movements, other techniques and tactics that he wants to sit. Now, what you don't want to do. So look at my competitor here working the bag in the proper way. Now look, now watch me. This is not applied to the ring at all. How would some work like this, even if I'm doing everything technically proficient, even if I have my hand out, how is staying posted in one area really going to transfer to me having better skills, stamina, tactics, conditioning there in the ring?
If your opponent is getting the ropes curled up like an armadillo.
Sure, why not? But a better way is just like Mr. Ivanov is doing. You turn this bag into an opponent. You make this bag react the way a real opponent would. You try to work the tactics, the techniques, the conditioning, all of
so
a real
keep
life
moving,
situation.
Moving.
It's not only keep moving. It's move in a way that you would move to be successful in the ring. So, but this should be said though, you know, you have to build up to it. So a guy who's never been in front of a heavy bag in his life, yeah, you do have to teach.
Should start stationary.
Yeah, but then eventually, you know. Can I switch you, Dave? Can you go on the water bag? So look, eventually, yeah, you know, you want to be working this, turning him, right? Maybe pivoting him into shots. You want to practice having your hand up. Right, and if I'm gonna jab at this back, I'm gonna jab to initiate some movement out of it the same way I would my opponent, and then boom, I can move him into a shot. Keep my feet moving, maybe some bobbing and weaving, maybe some slipping, maybe some combo punching, right? Never not doing anything. Never not actively trying to initiate something.
What's the most common mistake that you see as a trainer with people working a heavy bag here at your gym?
Staying stationary.
Okay.
Or this, I hate this. Boom, 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 boom. Grab the bag, put it back in place. Boom, 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 boom. Grab the bag, put it back
in
place.
Why don't you like that?
You don't grab your opponent that way. Your opponent doesn't let you maneuver them into the position that's advantageous for you to throw. So, hit this bag. Boom, boom, boom. When it comes, you gotta move, right? Or when it comes, you gotta walk it into some punches. But you may not stop the bag, reset yourself, and start punching.
How about this, Brandon? What about keeping your off hand, the hand that's not punching up? Because many times people hit the bag and the hand doesn't protect
you. You don't want to get lazy on anything.
It's habits, right?
You don't want to drop your defending hand. You don't want to get lazy with your punches. And in boxing, what that means is you throw a nice, beautiful punch, but then you drag it back. So you want to make, again, everything as applicable to the ring as possible. One other thing that I'll say that I see a lot of mistakes in. Joseph, come here. Hit the bag and then keep your fist there, like, and just keep it frozen. Yeah, go. Boom. Ah, Joseph's just learning, so we're not gonna hold this against him too much, but he's doing that no-no that I hate, because right now what Joseph is practicing is having his fist in this position. But Joseph knows that I always like my fighters to land with their knuckles first. So it may seem insignificant, but now he's going from punching with a shitty surface area, in a way in which his hands can break, in a way in which he finally lands that punch and it doesn't do anything to his opponent, to now taking all his energy, put it into the tip of those knuckles where he can really slice through what he's trying to hit. Now Joseph hit with those knuckles first. Better, sir, better. That's why he comes to the gym.
There you have it, Brandon Krause, the quick crash course, how to work the heavy bags, right? Move, hit and move, hit and move. Don't stick around. FaceReport.com, Melissa Back reporting.